In this video, I'll share with you guys the products and the process I use to cut and buff your airbrush work to a show quality result. The cutting and buffing process has never been one of my favorite parts of this job, but it kind of goes with the territory, especially if you're working in an automotive environment. So if you're not familiar with the process, the way I did this throughout the majority of my airbrush career is I would start by wet sanding the vehicle with 1000 grit sandpaper, then I would move to 1500 grit, to 2000 grit, to 2500, ultimately ending at 3000 grit before I ever put any compound on the vehicle. So imagine wet sanding an entire vehicle 5 times just to get it smooth and flat before you ever start putting the shine back into the paint. It's an enormous amount of work and it takes a lot of time. That's what I used. I used a number of different compounds over the years. Some worked better than others, but ultimately the process stayed the same up until about 3 or 4 years ago when I started using a different product line and cut out some steps based on what this product can do, which really cut the time and the work way down and you still get spectacular results. So it all starts with water. I'll fill up a bucket with some water and I add a little bit of Dawn dish soap. And the dish soap just helps to keep your sandpaper clean, keeps it from getting gummed up with the clear that you're sanding off the vehicle. So the way this process works now is I only use 1 grit of sandpaper to sand the vehicle. I only have to sand the vehicle 1 time. I'm using 1000 grit and it's a good idea to allow your sandpaper to soak in the soapy water for about 10 to 15 minutes before you get started. So the sandpaper has had time to soak and we can start the sanding process. It's a good idea to use a block, whether it's a hard block like this or a softer block. It's a good idea to use a block when you're sanding, whether you're doing a vehicle or just a panel, it doesn't matter. If you use just the palm of your hand while you're sanding, the problem is that the palm of your hand is not flat. You can actually create waves in the clear coat if you sand with just your palm. So make sure you use a block. I'm gonna use a hard block on this. You wanna make sure and keep your sandpaper and the surface you're sanding wet. And use a crosshatch pattern when you're sanding. Again, this is just 1000 grit sandpaper. And the idea is to sand the orange peel out of the clear coat. You want a flat surface before you start the polishing process. And I don't use a lot of pressure. Very minimal, just let the sandpaper do its job. As far as when you should actually cut and buff your clear, that depends on the clear that you're using. Not all clears are created equal. Some dry and cure a lot harder than others. So it's always best to check the manufacturer's technical data sheet and find out what they recommend. Of course, you can check your progress during this process just by drying the surface off. At this point, anything that you see that is still shiny means that you haven't got it sanded down flat yet. I can see along this edge and along this edge, there's a little bit of lip where the clear built up on the edge. and I'm still missing flattening it out just a little bit. So I can sand on this just a little bit more. I'm not too terribly concerned with this panel. It was just a test panel for another video, but I'll sand on it just a little bit more and then we'll start the buffing process. So for the purposes of this video, I'm going to call that good enough. It's super smooth, almost perfectly flat, not quite. There's a couple little areas I could hit a little bit harder if I wanted to, but for demonstration purposes, this is going to work. The advantage of using the 1000 grit is it cuts down the clear pretty quickly. It didn't take long for me to sand this panel out. And that's great. The one thing you need to keep in mind though is make sure you have enough clear on the vehicle or whatever you're buffing before you start this process, because we are removing material. By sanding the clear flat, we're removing material. Once we go to the compound, we'll be removing material. So keep that in mind when you're clear coating. You don't want to sand through the clear and into your artwork. So I put the timestamp in the sanding portion of the video we just saw, so that you guys could see exactly how long I actually spent sanding that panel without having to watch 10 and a half minutes of me sanding. The idea behind that is, now imagine that I went from 1000 grit to the 1500 to the 2000 to the 2500 all the way to 3000 grit. I would have to spend about the same amount of time with each different grit of sandpaper, because the idea is you want to sand the previous sand scratches away. You're working towards a finer and finer and finer scratch. That gives you less work when you're actually buffing. So all told, I would have spent probably about an hour on this very small panel just with the sanding process before I ever got to rubbing it out with any compound. The beauty about the products that I use now, which are Sonax, and I'll just say that I'm not associated with or sponsored by Sonax in any way. I use these products because they work and they work very well. One of the great things about Sonax products is they're water-based. So they don't give off all the dust that other compounds do, which makes cleanup a whole lot easier and a whole lot faster. Another great thing about Sonax is it uses diminishing abrasives. So what that means is we can get away with sanding with just the 1000 grit sandpaper, because the diminishing abrasives, as those abrasives are diminished through the buffing process, you're actually putting finer and finer and finer scratches into the clear coat. So the first step in the process is to use the Cutmax with the wool pad. One important thing to note here is with the Cutmax, you have to use a rotary buffing machine. You cannot get away with a dual action polisher for this process. If you're using a new or a dry pad, you need to prime it first. All that entails is putting a little bit of material onto the pad and then rubbing it in. Once you have a little bit of the compound in the pad, you can put a few more little dollops of compound on there. And we're ready to start buffing. I like to kind of dab the surface just a little bit so I don't spin compound all over the place when I start the buffer. But other than that, we're good to go. The buffer's set at probably around 1800 RPM, and I'm not using any extra pressure. The weight of the buffer itself is all you need to get this done. Let the wool pad and the compound do the job for you. And talking about how clean these Sonax products work, I'm buffing this inside my studio. With any of the other products that I've used over the years, there's no way I would have done this in the studio. I would have taken it out to the shop. So that just speaks volumes about how clean, you know, you'll get a little bit of lint from the wool pad, but that's about it. And this panel is relatively small, so I can cover the entire panel with one pass. But if you're working on something larger, just work in small areas. And it's hard to tell on camera, but you'll start to see the shine coming back in the clear coat, and that's when you know the compound is working. So work it until you're happy with it, and then move on. So after that step, I'll just take a dry microfiber. Clean the rest of that compound off. And already it's got a brilliant shine. For the next step in the process, I'm actually going to switch to a dual action polisher, and I'll be using the EX0406. This is the last step in this process, and the EX0406 will actually put a final polish on the panel, and it will give it good protection as well. And for this, I'm going to use a Sonax red pad, polishing pad, and it's the same process. This pad is dry, so I want to add a little bit of material to the pad, spread it around just a little bit, and then I'll put a few drops onto the pad as well. Kind of spread that out on the panel, just like we did before I start the machine. Same thing here, I'm not putting any more pressure on the panel other than the weight of the machine itself. And my dual action polisher is running on high, it's as fast as it'll go. Same thing, we'll grab the microfiber towel and wipe away the excess. I'm not sure how well this will actually show up on camera, but the results are just amazing in my opinion compared to the amount of work that I used to do with other compounds and the amount of work that I can do now. It's got Sonax has a really long working window, so you don't have to keep wetting the surface while you're buffing. It's just an all-around great product. If you haven't tried it, I'd urge you guys to give it a shot. There you have it. Like I said, these Sonax products have really changed the buffing process for my work. It saved me so much time and so much labor, and it still yields outstanding results. We already talked about the sanding. If I had gone through with the other four grits of sandpaper, I would have easily spent an hour just sanding that panel. Some of the compounds I've used in the past have, some have used just one compound, others have used two, some have even used three. Sonax uses two, which is completely doable. You saw by the timestamps in the video that I had just under about 20 minutes to cut and buff that panel. Now granted, I could have spent a little bit more time on it if I really wanted to make it perfect, but compared to some of the processes and the products that I used in the past, I probably would have spent at least an hour and a half, maybe a little bit more on a panel of that size. So another great thing to mention about the Sonax products is with that long working window, it actually helps to prevent burn through, which is an issue, especially if you're new to buffing. So that's something else to consider. I'll leave a link in the description to the Sonax products that I used. I hope you guys got something out of this. If you did, remember to like, subscribe, and share, and I'll see you guys next time.